We bless God. Okay. I think it needed we prophetic teaching this. We are challenge. The time was 7. Let me push and see if I can finish at least at 8 sharp. Just for an hour. So we're going to see that. As if we Exodus chapter number 3, verses number 1 to 5.
Verse 1. Mm-hmm. Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law.
Okay, if you have a little bit, let us pay attention. Let us pay attention. Whenever prophets and apostles speaking, there's a shift in the spirit. Hallelujah. It's not just information, but there is a reading in the spirit. And if you can dive into a movement as I'm speaking, your life is going to shift. Hallelujah. So listen to the story, not that the story you normally listen to. Listen it as in the context of your own life. Can you be Moses today? Mm. Hallelujah. Today you are Moses. You're being a little Moses. Today you are Moses. So if you zo fungela kanjalo, so she just figure like me to say kwan. Yeah, tell us phone.
This one. Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian, and he led the flock to the backside of the desert and came to the mountain of God.
Most normally would tend the flock of Unkwewake, Jethro, the father-in-law. But on this particular day, he tended them until he got to the mountain of God, Hebron. Amen. Okay. This occurrence, it was not a norm. Hallelujah. He will tender it just around the mountain. But on this day, he went to the west side of the wilderness. You know, something propelled him. Went to the west side of the wilderness and he came to Hebron, the mountain of God. Okay, let's go.
And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the fire was not consumed. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burnt.
You see what is happening here. Moses notices. Hallelujah. Moses, we are noticing something unusual is happening. Hallelujah. Okay, let's go.
And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see.
When the Lord sees that now Moses is turning aside to see.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Meaning, if Moses could have just walked away, God wasn't going to say anything. Moses was going to miss the opportunity. Hallelujah. But when God saw that this man is a detailed man, man who notices details, and then God began to speak. Let's go.
God called unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses, and he said, Here am I. And he said, draw not nigh hither, put off thy shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground.
Father, we bless you for your word. Speak to us on this day. We anticipate a shift in the spirit of God. We anticipate your glory. Rain and thunder shift our mindsets. Oh, sifundise umqondo wakho, sifundise indlela zakho,
You said in Isaiah 54, your ways are higher than ours, and your thoughts, oh God, are higher than ours. But you also say in the book of Corinthians, Zambulile ngomoya. Father, siyabonga ukuthi in the New Testament, oh God, your ways are revealed by the Spirit, even if they are higher. But in the Spirit, we can enter in there and begin to understand your ways. And today we are here, Father, so that we can understand the dealings. We can understand how you deal with us, how you deal with men. We give you praise and we honor you. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah.
I said yesterday, I've given this prophetic teaching entitled 80. When God interrupts you, be interrupted. Hallelujah. There are two words. Kunegama elithi interruption, nelithi disruption. Amen. E disruption, it is when the process is destroyed. When we speak about disruption, we are speaking about a process being destroyed. But when we speak about interruption, we speak about a break, a pause. It's going to resume. Hallelujah. You see, in disruption, it breaks the process so much so that the continuation is sometimes unknown to the person who gets yenzekeliyeni. It's more like death, like ufakomuntu. Many people, when a person dies, if there is a disruption, hallelujah. When a person dies, it's unknown. You can only experience them because an doesn't pile without them. So a disruption in a pain, hallelujah. In disruption, in a force, we must call it a disruption. In a force, normally it comes with a force. Sometimes it comes with pain, hallelujah. But it comes with total change, amen. Moses was a man who experienced both. He experienced the disruption and he experienced the interruption. Disruption, he had force to respond. But the interruption, it's up to you to respond. And that is what many people miss. They miss the opportunities that are carried by interruptions. Because interruptions are not painful. They are a pause. But they carry a weight in the spirit that can shift you to your destiny. You know, when you grow and go see, you cool and go see, unkulunkulu would not all the time use disruptions to move you to a next level. But when we have learned the ways of God, God will interrupt you. And your response, in order to determine what he, do you move forward with God or you go back to what you were? Many people have missed a great shift in their journey because there was nothing powerful, nothing loud. Our interruptions are not loud, they are very soft. But people ever pay attention to the things of the spirit. They can dig my interruptions and fight. They are so mysterious, our interruptions. But our disruption, they are so loud. Even if my full look shift, I made an example of death. Even knowing my full look shift, you are forced to. Hallelujah. But in Namkhandon, this is another way that God can, he will not be using pain all the time to shift you to the next person. Abanye abantu bazokuthi uNkulunkulu uzodina namfanele ngize ngidlule kuhlungu. Mina, I feel in my heart ukuthi when you grow to a particular level, uNkulunkulu will just interrupt you in hope ukuthi you're gonna yield. Hallelujah. particular people to come your way. Yeah. They don't carry any pain, but their appearance in your life, it's an interruption. And if you can dig why I met that person, you will find ukuthi it was an appointed time for a shift. But when abantu who are so ignorant, ukuthi they think it's just common that I met this person. It's just common that I went to the service. It's just common that we had this huge conference. For them, it's just one conference after the other. Abanye abantu bafunda ngokuhlungu. And I'm trying to find me. I feel like if unawa lalela ama interruptions, you will learn by disruptions. If you don't yield to interruptions, then it will mean that you will need to bring something heavy, bruising, so that you yield. But he does not intend to deal with you with disruptions. Hallelujah. We bless God. I said interruption is a break in a continuous process. It's a stop. It's a temporal stop. It's a pause of an ongoing process or an activity. It's not necessarily bad. The interruption will not be necessarily bad. You can restart without any demand. You can restart your life. You can encounter God in interruption and not know that you've encountered God, and then go back to your ordinary life and miss what God had brought in for you. Hallelujah. So I said to you, Moses experienced them both. Both divine disruptions and interruptions are a push to destiny. Both disruptions and interruptions are a push to destiny. Go Exodus chapter number 2, verses number 11. Exodus chapter number 2, verses number 11 to 15. Verses number 11 from the Adanja, Exodus 2. Who is it to show? Lana, we are seeing a disruption. Hallelujah. One day when Moses had grown up, he went out to his people and looked on their burdens. And he saw an Egyptian beating a Hebrew, one of his people. He looked this way and there, and seeing no one, he struck down the Egyptian and hid him in the sand. You see, he's a victim. He's not in control. It's a disruption. His life has been disrupted. When he went out on the next day, behold, the two Hebrews were struggling together. And he said to the man in the wrong, "Why do you strike your companion?" He answered, "Who made you a prince and a judge over us? Do you mean to kill me as you killed the Egyptian?" Then Moses was afraid and thought, "Show me the thing is known." Disruptions allowed. Hallelujah. Then Moses was afraid. He said, "Surely the thing is known." When Pharaoh heard of it, he sought to kill Moses. But Moses fled from Pharaoh and stayed in the land of Midian. Disruptions are forceful. Hallelujah. Now we see a man who has been disrupted. There is no way, even if he decides to remain in Egypt, it means that he's going to go to prison or he's going to be killed. Hallelujah. So it forces him to change. Now he goes away. He goes to the land of Midian and stay there and hide there. Exodus chapter number 3, the one that we read. Now God is speaking to Moses in the interruption. Hallelujah. Do you see ukuthi uma Moses ubengazanga yield to the interruption, something worse could have happened. Hallelujah. So the interruption can be easily missed. Hallelujah. Yeah. I wrote here, many people ignore interruption because divine interruptions are not loud and they are not painful. The Bible says Moses is tending the flock and suddenly he's drawn. Hallelujah. he's just drawn to the west, and then he encounters the mountain of God, and then he notices there is a tree burning, but it is not consumed. And if Moses could have ignored the tree, he could have missed an opportunity of his ordination into the leadership of the children of Israel. I'm going to encourage you, Bazalwane, be student of your own life, of your own spiritual life. Do not take things for granted. Do not take, especially people of God who stand before you for granted. Do not allow familiarity to make you miss moments and opportunities that had a potential to shift you. Hallelujah. I wrote here and I said, divine interruptions are so mysterious. They are so mysterious. Amen. If you don't ask, you will never know. Amen. Hence, Bazalwane, we need to live a life of expectation if we are in God. Ayikho into eyenzeka by coincidence. You don't meet particular people just because. You meet them because God has a greater purpose in prayer. Oh, hallelujah. When do disruption comes? When I answer that question, you're going to pray. They come when you are on routine. Uma uso round in taba. Oh. They come when you are no longer on purpose. Divine disruption, they come when you are committed on routine. When it's no longer fruitful. Whatever that you are doing is no longer serving the purpose of God. Then God will occasion interruptions. Hallelujah. Divine interruption will come when you are not doing the purpose. Do you know what? There are people who are at the place of purpose, but who are not doing purpose. There are people who are dynamic worshippers, but you will never see them joining worship team. There are people who are good with sound system, who are good with media. They are in a place of purpose. They are on routine, but they are not doing what God is ordaining. Interruptions come when God is saying, Uguti, you are not at your full potential. Hallelujah. The reason why Moses got to the land of Midian, it was not to tend the flock. But God wanted his attention. And God is seeing this man. This man has so much potential. Let me see if I can interrupt him, if he's going to yield. And then he comes. He pushes him to a place of divine assignment. Hallelujah. And we bless God that Moses yielded. Interruption comes when God sees you that you are in a desert. Interruptions comes when God sees that you are now common. You are now common. God will try to interrupt your routine. Sometimes interruption comes when you are serving the purpose of the other and not your purpose. Moses was tendering the flock of Jethro. But Moses had his purpose. So God said, can we jump in? Of course, we wouldn't want to train by serving someone else. He will train him. I'm not taking to serve other one's purpose. I'm not taking out of the equation. There's a time where God will use you, will train you by serving someone else's purpose. But at the time where God wants you to do what he has called you, he will interrupt you. My God, interruption, Bazalwane, they are so quiet. You can meet your appointment at the restaurant. meet your divine appointment at a restaurant. That was God interruption. God was interrupting you. How to unlock interruptions. It is my prayer that you do not miss divine interruptions. My prayer today is that may your eyes open. I had some question on the other phone. I was like, and every time when I'm there, I'm an interruption. When I'm moving, I'm like, why am I meeting this person? What brought me here? I'm telling you, some of you being in this local church, it's God interrupting you. Why? The time you begin to ask the why I'm here. Why am I here? You will not be able to get the reason why God brought you here. What brought you here? What brought you here? It's a question that you must answer. Even if you're going to chale, because you would have an answer. What brought you here? What brought you here? Are you brought by your emotions? Are you brought by two other times in this age? Love. Not only come in danger. Yeah, so the age. Okay. Ulan the age of the age. Must figure any angel. So I'm going to put as a pump as an angel. What brought you? Why are you here? And if you are here as well, going after the lust of your flesh, you're going to be disappointed. But those things are not going to be met.
Yeah.
What brought you? Is it the love for God? Is it the love for the word of God? It is because you understand this is a place where your purpose is going to be crafted. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So when you are interrupted and suddenly you are drawn, you see Moses was drawn to people. Suddenly you are drawn, you must ask yourself, what drove me here? Maybe it's a friend. If it's a friend, I'm telling you, the day they are leaving, they're going to leave. You're going to leave.
Yeah.
If you feel in group, the day they are leaving and you did not answer your why, where? Because you're going to see a woman in this journey. On a decision, only I am the year of super leave. I need to answer the word. Why am I here? I'm here because I saw the people in my phone and I'm similar. I'm so thankful. I'm here because I saw you on online. It needs to be deeper than the online. Come on. It needs to be deeper than the online. Also, Peter, the reason why we follow you is the words of life. Jesus, we don't follow you because you just there. See, Lord, you don't need to be there. Let's go with the person who can be the leader of us. We have a good thing to have a good. So, if they send us in a matter, it is because of the. Are you here? Because your spirit is hungry for the word of God. Because that is what we have. I'm sorry, we are not called for it. When was the one yesterday? We were not even called. Oh, what is wrong about God from Captain Mount? Tell me, my date here to so preach it in my life.
Yeah.
Oh, God, who is Quenza? You see, Quenza, because it's good.
Yes.
You see, Zanubani is the good about God to Mabashima is it?
Hallelujah.
I'm not going to try and design about one about Paul. But I'm telling you, I'll hand you with my date. Your means a lot color. What means a lot color is that we preach the way of life to God. To be diverted so that we are loved. For the stars, you must be mandate months. Then come go in a sequenza because it is good. Hallelujah. It is a character of our the gospel that we are preaching. But we have a mandate to minister the word of God. How to unlock. Said you ask questions, why am I here? What brought me here? Who brought me here? Hallelujah.
were you brought by the Spirit of God? It needs to be deeper than that.
Hallelujah. It needs to be deeper than that. Where did you hear about us?
Yes, we were online, but I also took time by myself to check who are this woman and man that God has called me to follow. Where am I following? So I don't know what was why. Imagine Jesus just started talking about demon God. They were confused. Because you know, we want to know where he's doing.
There's a story. I said you unlock it by asking questions. Amen. There's a story in Luke chapter number 24, verse number 13. The Bible said that very day, the two of men were going to the village named Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. And they were talking with each other about all these things that had happened. While they were talking and discussing together, Jesus himself drew near and went with them. Then interruption, eh? But their eyes were kept from recognizing. And when he said to them, "What is this conversation that you are holding with each other as you walk?" And they stood still and looked sad. Then one of them, named Cleopas, answered him, "Are you the only visitor to Jerusalem who does not know what the thing has happened there in these days?" Verse 19. And he said to them, "What things?" And they said to him, "Concerning Jesus of Nazareth, a man who was a prophet, mighty indeed, and the word of God, and all the people, and how our chief priests and rulers delivered him to be condemned by death and crucified him. But we had hope that he was one of the Redeemer of Israel. Yes, and beside all this, it is now the third day since these things happened. Moreover, some women of our company amazed us. They were at the tomb early in the..." You see these people, hallelujah. "They were at the tomb early this morning," 23, "and when they did not find his body, they came back saying that they had even seen a vision of an angel who said that he was alive. Some of those who were with us went into the tomb and found a woman and said, 'But him they did not.' And he said to them, 'Oh, foolish ones and slow of heart to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Was it not necessary that Christ should suffer these things and enter into his glory?" Hallelujah. I want to go to verse number 28. "So they drew near to the village." Amen. Hallelujah. Now I'm looking at 27, it says from 28, but 27, it intrigues me because it took them to notice the way this man is interpreting scripture is uncommon. Hallelujah. Jesus began with Moses and all the prophets. He interpreted to them in all the scriptures the things concerning himself. So 28, 40, "So they drew near to the village to which they were going. He acted as if he were going afar." You see some interruptions, Alan? At plain sight, you might miss them. Then the Bible said, "But they urge him strongly, saying, 'Stay with us, for it is towards evening, and the day is now far spent.'" How do you unlock interruption? By devotion. Hallelujah. They urge him strongly. I said, "Kokala, you need to ask questions.
Why am I here?
You know, it was not part of your plan. It was not part of your plan. Suddenly you find yourself, why am I here? Could it be the God is speaking to me? Could it be? Why am I here? It was not part of my journey. I did not see myself this weekend in Gilan. I did not have it in my plans. Then the Bible says, when the born Jesus matured, they urge him. You need to devote. Hallelujah. Devotion by prayer. Asking God, what is to delay on that weekend? This sermon was motivated in my heart when he attended the conference of Pumagion. Because I'm a student of the movement of God, I said, Lord, it could not be that we are just here. Yeah. I know that you are here because you want to push us to another level. It means there was a routine at the CCDO. Yes. When it's something that you never planned. You never planned. You didn't even see it coming. But when it means that God would have purpose about us to shift us to another place. You can't let it go like that. It can't be the memory of photos. It can't be the memory of the trip. Hallelujah. You need to take fastings. You need to pray. I remember after those days, I was not the same. I felt in my heart something had happened to me. I could not even pray in my office. I felt like I needed to grow. Hallelujah. But we don't come on. We enjoy trip with family. Store, we were there. I'm not looking for mina personally. This is a disruption. He uses it to turn it around for my own good. But the time where God, he is just going to allow you to be in a place and watch you. How are you going to respond after it? Oh my God, I feel so bad for people who colonize divine visitations because they don't give themselves time. I mean, they have different. There were interruptions and disruptions.
Yeah.
The people, when I studied the world of the spirit. How many they were distracted? They were, no, this is a disruption because God is speaking. It was just that moment when God was just wanting our attention. And I'm here on check. That have you devoted yourself? Have you come out? Have you received? Do you have a revelation about you personally? Do you have a revelation why? The whys. Have you answered the whys? So you devote. Listen, they urge him strongly. They urge him strongly. Immediately, they had to persuade. They had to persuade the cloud to release the rain. Your life must change. When you listen to them, your life must change. When our occurrences are friends, you must devote yourself. Hallelujah. So you unlock by devotion. Some of you have a backlog.
Right.
Backlog of unlocking interruptions. We have a backlog. Many good things have happened to you, you did not see them. Your eyes can only see.
Because if you miss such opportunities and occurrences, then you will learn by pain. You will not graduate to it. So you will feel like a pain. So you will feel like a pain. And I might even experience after this about your pain. Saying as it's all I'm gonna say, your systems are not just accepting you, and asking my sins and John shooting condemnations. But God does not intend to teach us about the pain all the time. And ask questions and realize, I need to be the same. The person that I encountered was not just a mere, that person was sent by God to me. You need to build a system. Come and let go once, if you open the level, we all took our foot away, you met God. When a prophetic word, you know, interruptions. When God gives a prophetic word, it's interrupting you of being common and being normal. And you need to build a system. When a prophetic word, what must you tell him? The course of your life must change.
Oh, yeah.
I have a son who has a prophet. Because it was a twala. I'm a miss opportunities. I'm a need.
My God.
Someone who collecting prophet, you don't do anything about them.
My God.
The people who dream of angels, so God, it's a good conversation to share with their friends, just to show them what spiritually inclined. They don't build systems. So the dimension where angels, it's just your common. You know when they say big them on doing, you know it's okay. Because I'm driving, say the hell they go. To their experience, it's a once occurrence, it's your daily life. But only visitation of angels, it means you did not devote, you did not ask the wise, you did not even build systems. You need to build systems. Build system how? You build system by prayer. How many they need a special offering? Hallelujah. How many they need a special offering to anchor yourself in that interruption? The reminder of Jacob, that when everyone would say, this is the house of God, Bethel. Hallelujah. The man said, this is a good interruption. This is just not common. It's just not the other dream. I've seen something that even my family, when I was just on my walk, this interruption, it's worth noting. Hallelujah. Read a scripture. First Corinthians chapter number 2. I don't know if we sit on a seat from the but we can go there now. This is one of scriptures that I love dearly. First Corinthians chapter number 2. Verse number 6, yet among the mature we do impart wisdom, although it's not a wisdom of this age or of the rulers of this age who are doomed to pass away, but we impart a secret and hidden wisdom of God, which God decreed before the age of our glory. None of the rulers of this age understood this. For if they had, they would have not crucified the Lord of our glory. But it is written, what no eye has seen, no ear heard, no heart of man imagined, what God has prepared for those who love him. These things, hallelujah, God has revealed them, and hallelujah. Yes.
Let it go as in your bed, no eyes are seen, no ear heard, not conceived in the eyes of men. Then move verse number 10, Articota. God has revealed them out to us as us. So many times in the end of the world, the head is not to us as us. Oh, hallelujah. So it's possible that you can know a part of the mind of God. Though you can't fathom God completely because it's vast. But you can know there are dimensions that are released. You can know about your future.
Amen.
Yes, that is good. That God is got intentions of you to have a good life.
Amen.
That's the mind of God about your future. Amen. That you can dive into why have I been interrupted like this? You can just let it, you must ask, why was I so pressed to do what I did there? And then there's something he come and looking for yet. And you will find out it was something greater than just money. God wanted to attend something in your life. But God has really all as a one. There are things that are readily available to us by the Spirit of God.
Yeah.
But God has revealed them unto us by His Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things.
Yeah.
Can you say all things?
All
things. I'm speaking to students. He knows formulas. Learn all things. He knows. The Spirit of God. That is man. Hallelujah. There's a Spirit of God that is in man. Hallelujah. So by His Spirit and searches all things. Must it yay? The deep things. Oh, hallelujah. Things that are unknown by man. But if you carry the Spirit of God, you will know that deep things of God. I want you to pray right there. Can you begin to pray? Shabaka imani ribasika tope la rasi. Kuraga shante reoso kota pararose. Le brakanto pelarose. Rakatore bakasera babosanta pelarose. Le brakanto redabosianta reboboshika te parose. Le brakanto boshanta le brotai. You know that the Spirit of God can locate people about a fair like in the linear. He knows everything. Things lost. About the book of Abraham, one was in good by young. But the Spirit of God knows all things, the deep things. All things, the deep things. Kurabasha, the things that are done in secret. Of God, if you can dig deep and devote, he can tell you why you're not moving forward. He can tell you why you are stagnant in your Christian life. Some of you today are being reminded how you have missed God's interruption, how you ignored them, how you thought that dream was just a dream. Father, we pray for our ears. We pray, Father, that from today now on, we become Father observers and watchers of your move. I always state a student, I say, consecration is a posture. Hallelujah. It is a posture of expectation. A person who expects God to speak is a person who consecrates. The more consecrated God can speak to
to you at any time. Hallelujah. When you read the book of Habakkuk chapter number 2, the book of Habakkuk chapter number 2, verse number 1, Uti, I will take my stand at my watch post. I will anticipate and station myself on the tower. I will anticipate. The reason why you can't correctly judge and see interruptions is because you are not expecting. People who are expecting God to move, when they see men and see events, they begin to ask God, why? Why? Until Habakkuk, I am going to station myself at the top because I anticipate God. This is a man who anticipates God. Hallelujah. And when God saw, from today, you're not going to miss God's interruptions. You're not going to miss God when he interrupts you. Oh, hallelujah. Do you know what? You can be interrupted by going to the loo in the middle of the morning. It's an interruption. But when you go with your eyes closed, because you know your house very well, so that you can go back to your bed immediately. But you know, Uti, I don't normally wake up around this time. No, check it out. 4:44. In Finnish language, the prophetic language. No, all four of us will go 3 for no reason. All three of us will go 3. Maybe it's in your place, I go 3:33. That's how observant I am in the spirit. Sometimes it will be a number. I will have to stretch for the number and pray on that number. Pray on it, because God will use anything. Prayer, we are walking with the Spirit God. He is not a man. Get out of A-O-O when he speaks to you. He will use symbols and signs. That's what it's called to you. Just wake up in the scattered to soul. Jalo mo cheki wash when 11. Jalo mo cheki wash 11. Now we need to stand back and say, God, what are you saying to me? You must be a student of your life. Because ukulukulu manati ngengele ingafani. There's a way ukulukulu akuluma akintarata wakana. I want you to be observant now. I don't want you to be carnal. Hallelujah, when they call you, even when they comment on your status, they've never done that before. Kufana noma usuwehle nkazimulweni, usuwehle nkazimulweni. It needs to. I kept myself in my salvation, done my share. Because of glory. You will interpret the events in your life differently. If you study, what did I learn from the mosque? Who made was way born in a sense? At least they must at least be a character. If you're Jesus Christ, I don't believe Jesus Christ. Then you will see that this is how God deals with me. Be expectant from today. You are walking with the Spirit. Who's of you Kuluma Nawe? Sometimes we're meeting them pray. Thinking more than those who are cut and pastel. Who value the object and felt that.
Let us stand on our feet. Let us stand on our feet.